Shalom, Yashalom, Shalom, Shalom, Kola Yahel, Bashem, Mashiach, Malaki, Oshay, Obakakadash, Tazwan, Kapaka, Pahim, Squire, and Wah, Kamish Allah, Habatam, again, Wah, Kwa. Man, I'm on a different dump. I'm on a different time zone. And men and women in the truth got to understand that you should be on a different time zone, right? Because, I mean, you ever tried to sit down in a place where it was a lot going on and try to count a whole minute, right? It's ever been 2:59 and you were waiting to throw up a prayer during the hour of prayer. You ever notice how long that minute go by? Don't they say in the world, every time you having fun, right, time go by fast? Right, so how can you apply these things and these subconscious things that are commonly known as true? How can you apply it and actually explain it to where, as though the scriptures say, we move on a different time than people in the world? The scriptures say, if you have a friendship with the world, you are enemy of God. So when you moving at a different time, when you moving at a different pace, right, when your goal is just different from the common goal, and I might be in school, I might be working, I might be doing whatever, so yeah, put some money in my pockets, but why am I putting money in my pockets is a whole different goal to where as though somebody else is doing it. You go to school, they give you a four-year degree plan. That four-year degree plan, what am I accomplishing within this 4 years? Is it the same as a freshman that came out of high school with a 4.0, right, in the world? Or is it the same as a brother that came into the truth, ninth grade year, he going to college for 4 years, and he graduated with a damn, you know, a 3.0, whatever it may be? Those are two different time zones. It's two different time periods. You got to understand that you don't move on the same accord as the world. You don't dance to the same drum, right, that this world creates, right? You don't dance to the same beat that this world creates, right? So the Most High's beat, the Most High's level, the Most High's tempo, the Most High's rhythm is completely different than it's not here on earth. It's not here on earth. So every time that you understand, you feel like you awkward, or you look at something as awkward. But I've been sleeping in the tent for the past 2 days for the Feast of Tabernacles. I'm not poor. I'm not homeless. But why am I sleeping in the tent? I'm keeping the commandments. That's a simple explanation as to why. But like, why? Why am I sleeping in the tent? Why do I feel so humbled from sleeping in the tent? I wake up in the morning from sleeping in the tent, get in the shower, get dressed, and go on my daily basis. How many people do you walk past on your day-to-day life that are homeless? That you walk past on your day-to-day life that don't have the same opportunity as you have? And they wake up in that same morning and they do the same, you know, they go throughout their daily routine. You go through your daily routine. You walk straight by them. How many times do you cast a judgment on a brother, or you cast a judgment on a sister without knowing what they've been going through that day or that week? How many times? How many times do you look at a brother falling short and you say, oh my gosh, here we go again, without actually applying Sirach 11 and 8 and actually understanding what that brother or sister is going to? So you can divide it on different time, on different levels. Me and you, all right, when it comes to our friendship, when it comes to our brotherhood, our sisterhood, whatever it may be, right? It's a different time. It's different times. Everybody's situation is different. My $100,000 might be different than somebody else's $100,000, right? My little understanding of Deuteronomy 28 might be different than somebody else's little understanding of Deuteronomy 28. It's always different. It's always on different time zones. And when you in this truth moving throughout the world, you always got to recognize that time zone and actually and pace yourself in this truth. All right, so I'm going to get two precepts. Precept number one is Romans chapter 6. Romans chapter 6 and verse number 17. Romans 6 and 17. But God be thanked, right, that ye were servants of sin, but ye have obeyed from the heart that formed of doctrine which was delivered unto you. Right, so God is thanked that you're allowed to continue in this truth. For the brothers and sisters that live out this truth and actually try your best, which I'm going to get into, you made that conscious decision to actually keep the Most High God's commandments, right? And you actually made that decision. That's God is being thanked for that, right? But verse 18 says, being then made free from sin, ye became the servants of righteousness. Meaning what? From that time point on, when you came into this truth, you were given the capability to choose not to sin. You were given the capability to choose not to sin, right? So every decision that you made throughout your day, you had a decision. I'ma actually go read instead of going to go smoke. I'ma actually go eating this, eat a salad, instead of eating a pulled pork sandwich with extra barbecue sauce. You are actually given a chance. You are given a conscious mindset for you to able to form a decision to not sin. You were made free from sin, right? And now ye were free from, verse 19. I speak after the manner of men because of the infirmity of your flesh. For as ye have yielded your members servants to uncleanliness and to iniquity, even so now yield your members servants to righteousness unto holiness. So nowadays, it should be such of a habit for you. You should be in the habit of reading, praying, and fasting. You should be in the habit of treating your brother correctly. You should be in the habit of looking at a matter, looking at a situation, and analyzing it in a certain way. You should be in the habit of these things. So now as time go on, you've shifted your life. You've shifted your paradigm that's different from what's going on. All right? So now as I live and I make decisions for my life, it's completely different than what else is going on. All right? All right? So you have no excuse to be faultless. You have no excuse to be held to where as though you're being worldly. You have no excuse to where as though you're being accused of moving on the same beat as this world, because the decisions I make is not the same as other people in the world, right? You're on a different time zone, man, right? Your 60 seconds is different than a person in the world's 60 seconds, right? My hour, my Sabbath day is completely different than a person in the world's Saturday. The things I do on a Sabbath day project me to go somewhere else than a different dude's Saturday is projecting him to go in the world. It's projecting you to a different place, right? And that's why it's almost so much tension and so much faith and so much substance being stirred up as time goes on, up and coming to the second coming of the Lord, man, all right? Because you're on a different time zone, right? The life that you live right now with the decisions that you make, every decision is important. Every single last decision is important, right? Because you got to think about your decisions, right? Now, one more precept. Let's go to Ecclesiastes. Chapter 8. All right. Well, but like the Lord said, the race is not to the swift, nor is the race to the strong. Right? In Ecclesiastes. Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and verse number 11. I returned and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor battle to the strong, neither yet bread to the wise, nor yet riches to the men of understanding, nor yet favor to men of skill, but time and chance happeneth to them all. Right? So every decision that you make in life is extremely important, right? Because my life is not on the same time. I'm not operating on the same speed. I'm not operating at the same momentum as you are in your life. So the outcomes and what I'm getting throughout my life is the fruit of my life, right? And what you do in your life and the outcomes you get from your life and the growth that you get from your life is the fruits that you get from your life. So understand that you're on a different time zone of this world and you're on a different time zone from the brother and the sister that's sitting right next to you, right? Because your lot is different than everybody else's. So how much different is the lot of the men and women in the truth versus the lot of the men and women in the world? And we haven't even talked about the heathen. Shalom.